Hey everybody. How are you?
How are you?
Great. Fantastic. I'm ready as I'll ever be. I've done all one man can. No one now will rescue me. So here I'll make my stand. The state police, they came around. They said I should not stay. I thank them for their kind concern and sent them on their way. I made my preparations. There's nothing more to do, Lord, Lord, but to sit here in this rocking chair. Waiting for the storm. We have a problem. The state, no. The wife and kids, they. All right, we gotta start this again because this guitar isn't working. That. Sorry. Are you either with me there?
Yes.
Pat? Yes. Talking to Pat. I'm gonna unplug this. And plug it in again. Can you divine from your vantage point where it's coming from? Talk to me, Pat. Please talk to me.
Sure.
You're not hearing the guitar disappear? Oh, well, from where I sit, the guitar is completely disappearing in the monitors. And I thought you could. Oh, it cut out a few times. Thank you. That could be it. You getting a nice strong signal there?
Yes.
Shall we try it again? Ready as I'll ever be. Done all one man can. No one now will rescue me, so here I'll make my stand. The state police, they came around. They said I should not stay. I thank them for their kind concern and sent them on their way. I've made my preparations. Nothing more to do, Lord, Lord, but to sit here in this rocking chair, waiting for the storm. My wife and kids, they've gone up north. Everything I've ever loved will soon enough be gone. I made my preparations. There's nothing more to do, Lord, Lord, but to sit here in this rocking chair, waiting for the storm. Lately I've been thinking, the windows open wide. I left the doors ajar, and everything that was inside I put out in the yard. I made my preparations. There's nothing more to do, Lord, Lord, but to sit here in this rocking chair, waiting for the storm.
Everybody's name here, because everybody here who works here is named Pat. Gotta do one thing.
Across
the valley and disappear into the trees. Two strands that seem to run through many of my songs for some reason, I don't know. One is all things having to do with highways and cars and driving and long distances, and the other is four-legged critters, animals, large mammals. This song unites the two great themes of mine. It's called The Deer on the Parkway. Right? It's right there in the title. It's fantastic. That's not the original title, though. The original title was The Deer on the Sawmill. Right. If you're not from New York, you don't know that the Sawmill River Parkway is a thoroughfare, a well-known thoroughfare in the north of the city. And, it, you know, not knowing that, the title of The Deer on the Sawmill might evoke an unpleasant image in your head before you've even had a chance to hear the song. So I changed it to Parkway. It's still unpleasant. Through the trees and kid ships and cells of sixes and threes, and following true to the call they obey, their eyes on the prize, each blade of the way.
considered him good. The odd royal arrow, a small price to pay for keeping the poachers and freedom at bay. And the deer on the parkway graze right.
Something I have no idea what. I got myself into a little metaphorical jag, and I ran with it, but I have no idea where it's running to. I do like it though. I could have fleshed it out or figured out what the metaphor is, but why? There's a highway song. There are no animals in this song, except for humans.
Old and piston. I knew them all by heart. We cleaned her out and painted her, brought her up to speed. I proudly put my name upon the Kenworth of my dreams. But sometimes, late out on some interstate, I hear those sad country songs. True love found and true love gone. Lately I just turned the damn thing off. Now a lot of folks just shook their heads, convinced that I'd lost mine. They said living in
someday. There's this New Yorker cartoon that used to have on my refrigerator. There was this guy in a very dark and dismal basement with one lit by one bare light bulb hanging from a wire, and he's sitting at like a desk, and his papers piled high everywhere. He's sitting at a typewriter. He has very bad posture. There's a woman standing at the top of the stairs. Light's coming from the door where she stands at the top of the stairs. And she looks, she has a look on her face like she's admonishing him or asking a question. And the caption reads, "Finish it? Why would I want to finish it?" Welcome. So here's a song from that record.
Excuse. The drink brought out the worst in me. wasn't me, it was me nevertheless.
It's amazing. You never know what they think of, what they will think of next. I mean, this is called an electric guitar. It's astonishing. I think it's going to be huge. I think it could change the face of culture.
For weary sinner and deliver me. deliver me, deliver me to the next best Western. Tremble in the hand that reaches out to take my quarter. I look him in the eye, but there isn't any time, just time enough to pass the tender. The highway takes its toll, the green light flashes go, and it's welcome to home. Show a little mercy for the weary sinner and deliver me, Lord, deliver me, deliver me to the next best Western. But it takes light years of nothing to let these stars shine through. It's an empty road that finds its way back home to you. At 4 a.m. on 80 East, it's in the nature of the beast to wonder if there's something missing. I am wretched, I am tired, but the preacher is on fire, and I wish I could believe. Whoever watches over all these truckers, show a little mercy for a weary sinner, and deliver me, Lord, deliver me, deliver me to the next best Western. To the next best Western. To the next best Western.
Thank you very much. Here's another four-legged animal song. It's kind of started them all off. This is like the mother of all the four-legged animal songs. They just came out of nowhere. I have no idea what deep psychological need this fulfills in my career or my life. It just felt like writing songs about cows and deer and in this case, a mule. Well, it's really nice. There's a human in this one. There's a guy who's, he's really, it's about a guy who's riding around on a mule named Clara. Beyond that, I have no idea.
Come on, Clara, don't look at me with those big sad eyes. Please, Clara, no use crying, it won't work this time. Enough is enough, we've been through this a thousand times. Ever since we started roaming to wherever it is we're going. Come on, Clara, be a good mule, now stop this farce. Please, Clara, the wind is cold and it's getting dark. Don't fail me now, get up, girl, I followed you this far. Out here beyond all knowing, and only you know where we're going. Clara, dear, I'm a
must have been a fool to ever listen to a mule, even one as cute as you. Ah, Clara dear, a soul's a heavy load when you're running out of road, and you can never go back to Rome. Come on, Clara, the map said there'd be monsters here. Did you hear that noise? Whatever it was, sounded wicked weird. Vandals, Celts, and Visigoths are everywhere. And this road ain't even Roman. Just where the hell are we going, Clara dear? I must have been a fool to ever listen to a mule, even one as smart as you. Ah, Clara dear, a soul's a heavy load when you're running out of road, and you can never go back to Rome. Something on the other side. We'll build a little fire there to get us through this night. Out here beyond all knowing, and only you know where we're going. Clara dear, I must have been a fool to ever listen to a mule, even one as sharp as you. Ah, Clara dear, a soul's a heavy load when you're running out of road, and you can never go back to Rome, and you can never go back to Rome, and you can never go back. To Rome. Do one more, and then we'll take a little break, at which point you may avail yourselves of the many and varied retail opportunities at the back of the room. I'm a lousy capitalist. Terrible capitalist. I have some records back there. They're okay.
St. Agnes's choir. There's a nun at
there changing a tire. By the time they got fire, tempers were out of control. So they all hit the gas in a dash for position, bobbing, weaving, flashing their high beams, flipping the bird, screaming obscenities, a well-insured horde, hell-bent on Saturday. So they continued westbound and into the sun. Law and decorum constraining nary one. By then was devil may care. Delaware water gap. But how had it happened? They had all missed their exits. How had it happened? Was it some kind of vortex? And in they all went, bumper to bumper, faster and faster, no sign of a trooper. And in they all went, like sheep to the slaughter. Bankers and carpenters, doctors and lawyers, and in they all went. Families in minivans, Democrats, Republicans, but mostly Republicans. They followed the river and rounded the bend between Mincy and Tammany, and into their destiny, lying in ambush right there before them. The angry old sun.
Thank you.
I've had this song in my head all day. I've never sung it before. Ever. Particular take on the song. It's usually not played that way, but some friends of mine over in Devon Phil Henry and Anna Martin bluegrass tune. This one is called, also from a new record. It's called Your Guitar. Choking. They're gonna kick my ass. Oh, Lord. It's a weird song. I just got this idea in my head. I had to do research for this song. I had to like figure out what I thought, which I never do. And so it was a... Well, I don't know what to say about this song. It's called Atlas Choking, or, in parentheses, Ion's Air. To do, but I just can't help making sense. It's really, really annoying, and I tend to do that with this song prior to writing those lyrics. I'm not sure they make sense, but this makes even less sense. You know what I mean? Like songs that just are like themselves. They're just, they don't point to anything. anything else. They're like performative. They're just in the literary sense. They just are what they are. It's like Shooby-Doo. Or I found my thrill on Blueberry Hill. It's brilliant. It's just, it is what it is. It's just, here's an example of me trying not to make sense. Here is a song, same melody, same chords. This is a song that seeks to avoid all significance, meaning, and purpose. And it's already failed insofar as a point was just made in that very first sentence. Likewise, the second, and this one, the third. Keep digging the hole ever deeper. Such are the wages of subject and object, united by means of a verb. But that's all right, cause with every failure I'm giving a slip to my logical jailer, and one step closer to walking away. Singing doo-da, doo-da. There's another verse, actually. I just saw it here. Songs need verses, and verses need words. And here are a few of my favorites. Ramshackle ballyhoo, trifle and muck, Daisy, feisty and loon, bloodlust, bother, quiver and frog, falderall, feather and moonbeam, bedevil, beloved, lurch and bewilder, murder, meander and mayhem. Really enjoy singing mayhem at the happiest part of the song. Tumble down, picnic, limbic, and shackle. Gibberish, jangle, jalopy, fandango. But sometimes a man's just gotta sing. Doo-da, doo-da. The song was gonna be called Doo-da. I may just have to record that. Thank you very much. Request for this one. Thank you. It's always nice to remember this one. Kind of slips by sometimes. You got a bunch of songs and some of them you just forget to put on the list. They just fall off the list for no good reason.
Wisteria.
He'll come right up to the window. It's kind of low down, and he just sort of looks in. He's ugly. He's so ugly. He's spooky looking too. He's really scared. It's just, and he just looks, and we look at him. He looks at us, and he looks at us like he owns the place, and we look at him like we own the place. It's a problem. And he's just horrible. And then we got skunks, and these little armadillos. Called peludos, and they're really stupid. They're just really stupid. They're blind, first of all. Not that that has anything to do with being stupid, but they can't see anything. And so you can walk right up to them, and even if you like, if you try to get their attention, they just don't react. They just don't. I guess they're sort of lulled into a sense of security by that thing. And what else we got? We got these big things called carpinchos, which is like a rat the size of a dog. Much cuter than in rats. And, is that what that is? And then we got birds. It's one of the most wonderful bird habitats in the world. We have like thousands of species. We have
The other day I was driving around and there was a family of Maguari storks, which is a huge thing, black and white. And we have flamingos, and it's beautiful. It's impossible to sleep past 6 o'clock in the morning because the birds are just outrageously noisy. They all go crazy. They wake up and they just, it's like they've all had too many lattes or something. And they just, well, this song doesn't really have anything to do with any of that. But it reminds me of the place. Because I wrote it sitting on the porch looking over at this road, which is a couple miles away where there are a lot of trucks go by. And a lot of trucks that bring the harvest to port. So I imagined a woman selling empanadas over there at a truck stop. It's called Mariana's Tape.
From the Union, which they day.
Wasn't it?
Interesting. Your diagnosis was an excellent one. Really?
Well, no, but there's a
different noise. There's a mute that there's a noise that makes it sounds like nothing to do with muting. So, the symptoms would have indicated that your diagnosis is correct, but it was not. So, we need Dr. House. It's not lupus. Let's see, what's it? No, I need this one.
Have some fun.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Came tonight. It's a Sunday night. It's a school night. And you came anyway. It's so nice of you to come. I love this place. It's one of my favorite places. The sound here is fantastic. And you all show up, and sometimes you bring your friends, and the food's good, and people are nice, and that's one of my favorite places to play. Last time I was here with a band, I figured I'd lay off the band for a while. Expensive, those guys.
With a cage.
And her mother
too far. She'll never survive here on her own, on her own. But the little girl's not listening. She's talking to the bird. Mavis, you can trust me. Now's your big chance. Fly away. Fly away.
wish I was a headlight on a northbound train. I'd shine my light through cool Colorado
for those years.